sa kandungan ng kaligtasan. Dito ako isinina sa kandungan ng kaligtasan. Dito ako nabubuhay sa kandungan ng kaligtasan.
We just came from a meeting with Partido Kalikasan, and I'm heading a new party. It's called Pangmasa, basically Partido ng Marangal na Sambayanan. We were exploring the possibility of how do we come together on the same principles. And I noticed that the agenda of Partido Kalikasan is very convergent with our own approach. That's why we're having exploratory talks. And these are the agenda of Kabuhayan, Katarungan, and Kalikasan. It's totally convergent with the pillars of our agenda, which is basically poverty eradication and quality of life, moral and effective governance with social justice, and then of course integrity of creation. But there are other aspects which I'll describe later. So what is the agenda of presidency of our party, of my presidency? We have six pillars in the agenda. The six pillars are the eradication of poverty, improving the quality of life for all. And foremost among this is a systemic approach towards poverty eradication, because poverty is a systemic problem. So this will of course include environmental concerns. You cannot destroy your sources of life and expect to sustain your economic operations. But at the same time, in this approach, peace and order will be very important. And in this context, priority is the peace agreements with the MILF and the government of the Philippines, as well as with the NDF and NPA, CCP. But both agreements will be based on installing a new order where social justice is very clear. You cannot negotiate just two words. You have to demonstrate the new political will to install social justice at all levels of governance. But to do that, it's connected to the second pillar, which is moral and effective governance. Therefore, this pillar of the party's agenda strives to actually eradicate poverty, corruption in the Philippines within the first year of office. I think it's doable. If there's a demonstration of political will on top of the leadership, it's definitely possible. There are 15 subject areas under this moral effective governance, which I will not touch on today. But most important with this is the proper public education and the opening up of all spaces to public participation and of governance. Number three, you cannot really sustain both the anti-corruption and the anti-poverty work if you destroy the environment. The environment is our sources of life. It's the source of our life. It's very important. Almost every aspect of environmental issue involves the whole question of environmental justice. In this way, it connects to the first agenda. So it's all interrelated. One of the things that I want to demonstrate, especially within the first 100 days, is to stop all the smoke belching in Metro Manila. Just to demonstrate that it's possible to go against the power in the system, whether it be powerful political interests, powerful military interests, powerful business interests. It is important to demonstrate that air pollution is a major hazard to the health of Filipinos. Hundreds of thousands are being compromised in their health due to the pollution. We have to show and concretely demonstrate that we can stop this. But of course, the agenda for the environment is much larger than just air pollution. It will involve solid waste, especially global warming is also part of that. The whole issue of mining, sustainable agriculture, genetic engineering, it's a huge agenda. And it's actually connected to the third question. What distinguishes my candidacy from the others is actually a very serious focus on addressing environmental issues. This is actually quite unique now in terms of a presidential candidacy, where the first three main pillars, environment is one of the three and interconnected with the rest. I'll just finish and then finish with three others just quickly. Building partnerships in society for social justice. Government has to be reformed, and we have to introduce the concept of governance. Governance is society-centered, while the prevailing political approach to governance is state-centered, just the government. You cannot change a society without involvement of civil society and business people who want something different. We are bringing in, we're opening all areas of government to the participation, profound participation from the beginning to the end of governmental processes, opening this up to civil society and to business. And in connection with this, and as a demonstration of appreciating any and all initiatives in the country which moves towards integral sustainable development, we will mainstream existing initiatives of people, of local governments, of socially responsible and ecologically responsible business that are actually working in a certain scale, and mainstream the lessons for the country as a whole. I don't care where it came from. As long as it really works and it's really effective, then we will mainstream visionary initiatives in education, in environment, anti-corruption, anti-poverty, microfinance, I mean the whole range of other aspects. And then finally, for the immediate as well as the long term, the sixth pillar of Pangmasa's agenda is holistic education and inner change. This is another aspect that makes this candidacy unique, because there will be a very strong cultural focus. Culture is the driver of development in the country, because culture deals with profound issues connected to worldviews, to values, to behavior. It's easy to say something, but to actually do it is something different. There has to be profound inner change at all levels of governance. And so we will be implementing projects that will bring back education to its true form, which means not filling buckets, but lighting fires, creative, critical fires inside, so as to fully develop the human being to participate in the reconstruction of the Philippines. Thank you.